In this video, you are going to know about centrifuge, that what is it, what is the use of it, and how to operate centrifuge. So let's get started to understand about centrifuge. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Biology with Agam Singh. So firstly, know about what is centrifuge. So centrifuge is an instrument. Firstly, it is an instrument, it is a microbiological instrument used for the separation of liquid material on the basis of their density and their weight. The best example which is related to the centrifuge, you can easily relate with that, that in our homes, our mother making buttermilk from the curd. As she is shaking the curd in a jar, in a shaker, in a large amount of RPM, about 2000, 3000 or more than the RPM. So it creates the butter on the upper side of the jar and buttermilk will got in the lower side. As such, the centrifuge works. Centrifuge work on the principle of sedimentation rate, means that the heavier particle will go in the lower side while the lighter particles will come upper in the side. So this is the principle working of the centrifuge. So it actually works on the centrifugal force, as you can study about that in physics, centrifugal force. So due to centrifugal force, the high mass particles will come in the bottom while the lighter will come upside. For example, in the microbiology, we can take an example. When we centrifuge the sewage water, then it contains lots of algae, protozoas, bacteria, and viruses also. So when we centrifuge it, we get a pellet. As you know, centrifuge differentiate the liquid material in the supernatant and the pellet. The supernatant is the uppermost part which is lighter, and the pellet is the lowermost part, the lower one. Okay. So when we centrifuge the sewage water, then centrifuging the sewage water will make a pellet in the bottom. So the bacteria, the protozoas, the algae, all will settle down in the bottom as a pellet, while the viruses will come upside in the supernatant, as they are lighter than bacteria, algae, and many more things that are present in the sewage water. So it is used to differentiate between the higher and the lighter organisms which are present in the liquid sample. Or it can also be used for not for living only, it also for non-living things also. Means that the higher lighter particle will come up and the heavier will goes down. That's all the principle on which the centrifuge works. Now let's introduce how to operate it. This is a centrifuge machine, means that it is an instrument, centrifuge. As you can see here, cooling microfuse, and in the side it is written that centrifuge. It is written, it is why it is written that cooling microfuse, because it is a refrigerator centrifuge. It works on different temperatures, lower the, as our fridge, our refrigerator in our homes makes the things to cool down. So this also works on that principle. It makes the it works on low temperature, about minus it also works in minus temperature, the negative temperatures. Okay, so firstly make it on and understand what is it. You can see that this is the timer which can you set. This is the RPM from which you have to rotate it about. It 4-digit RPM means that it is a high rotating centrifuge or microfuse. And this is the temperature. As you can see, this is minus 17 degrees Celsius. You can regulate this temperature from this knob, as it is minus 2 or whatever, you can make the temperature to on. This is the main and this is the motor. Motor means the on switch which can make it to on, and this is the regulator from which you can maintain the speed of it. As you can see, this is and the voice you can listen. This is rotating out. I had off it now. As you can see in the top, this is rotating. Okay, and the machine which cools it also become on when I on it. So I make it off now and
let you introduce that what is inside it. As you can see, this is a machine where the tubes, the append drops are kept out. So let's see it how the centrifugation is done. Firstly, we just have to open it, which I am opening that one. You just have to open it. You can see that there are many shelves here. This is the shelf, the points where we have to fit out the append drop tube, the centrifuge tubes, as we can also say them. These are append drop tubes because they are just smaller. You can set them here and just opposite to it. You just have to make a balance here. Means that no imbalance is required because it works on centrifugation force. So you just have to balance it, and after that, after putting that append drops inside, as you can see, this is filled up with the liquid material, the liquid sample which is inside it, and off it, and just make it tight so that it doesn't become open when it rotates. So make it tight, and after that, this is the safety glass, so that if it is loose, then this will not come upside and hurt you. So this is about it. And you have to, after putting that, you just have to on it. When on, then firstly make them the switch to on, and after that you can set the timer from here. As you can see, this is the timer point, and very slowly rotate the roller so that the RPM of the centrifuge will start. As you can see here, the RPM is increasing, 100, 200, 300, and it can go for a long as you can. And after that, centrifugation, whatever the time you set, after that completion of time, it automatically stops. And then you have to find the, and then you have to take the append drops out and see the results. See whatever you require, the pellet or the supernatant, whatever is required by you, you can take it out. Okay. Now here is another type of centrifuge, that is a different type of microfuse. It doesn't contain small wells for the append drop. It contains large well for the microfuse tubes, as it contains a very large surface for the more amount of liquid material to be separated out. So here also we just have to balance out. Means that in front of this will come, so that the balance will make. And here also, this is the cover of the centrifuge. You just have to make it tight, and after that make the glass to safety glass to on. And here also the same thing occurs, but here a different thing occurs, that is here you can see the brake is here in the centrifuge. The operating mechanism is very simple. Here also the timer set is also there, but here it is not chilled type or refrigerated centrifuge, so it doesn't show any time. It works on normal temperature. That's it. So I hope this video is helpful for you. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you have any query, then you can ask in the comment box down below. And if you haven't subscribed this channel, then subscribe the channel to get more interesting videos such like that. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.